Sangaramalai. It's a beautiful and an ancient village evidenced by Pidari Amman temple, which is located at the northern side of the village. A single granite hill rock is located here. At the top of the hill rock, there is Sankareswara temple. In the Sanctum Sanctorum, Lord Sankareswara appears as a linga form. Hence, this hill rock is called Sangaramalai. Every year, on the 10th day of the Tamil Chitrai month, sun adores the Sankareswara for 20 minutes by its rays. This evident denotes the fine and minute architecture of this temple. Jain monks had been in the areas of Tamil Nadu even before the arrival of them from Saravanabelagola of Karnataka state. It is evidenced by the stone beds of Jain monks in various parts of Tamil Nadu. Three stone beds are found under a big stone called Gundukal at the northern foothill of Sankaramalai. Nearer to these, a smaller cave is also found. It might have been used by the monks. They did social activities like healing of physical illness of public and educating them along with their spiritual activities. While teaching, students used the stone beds as their seat. For healing physical illness of public, they prepared medicines by using natural materials. For grinding the medicine, they used mortar, which are mostly found on the surface of the rocks. At the eastern part of the hill rock, there is another Gundukal with many mortars around it. This Gundukal is broader at its upper side and gradually narrows towards its bottom. The narrow bottom of the Gundukal that forms the sharp edge is attached to the granite surface. Even after many centuries with the natural disasters, this Gundukal remains stable without any movement, which surprises us. There are other stones similar to Gundukal as well, located at the top southern edge of the hill rock, which remain stable. It also surprises us. If we climb the hill rock from the eastern side, we can see there is a plain surface with three water storing pits. Two pits are rectangle in shape with soft edge, and another one is in wheel shape. People of this village call the wheel shaped pit as Chakrapali. In the middle of the south slope of the hill rock, there is a small cave. To reach that cave, there is no proper path. And the wall and the floor of the cave, we can notice instructions. Stone bed signs are also there. By these signs, we conclude that Jain monks might have been here. They might have used these beds as their humble residence. By 1926, granite stones had been cut off from the hill rock for construction purposes. It's unknown whether there had been any historical traces in the areas where granite stones have been taken away. At the western side of the Sankaramalai, there is a wall running in north-south direction for centuries. This wall is called Madukarai. Now it has become a road for public transport. It is said that this wall is a boundary line of Chola and Kongu dynasty. in the Trichinopoly Madras District Gazetteer published in 1907, mention a first century poetess Avaya had referred to this wall as western boundary of Chola dynasty. There are also temples for tutelary deities in Madukkarai. We can see a Karupusami temple at Madukkarai near Sankaramalai. Passing Madukkarai west of Sankaramalai, there is a plain rocky section with 17 pits. The people of the area call it as Pandapparai. Let us see where it is located. Sankaramalai is about 2.5 kilometers south of Manavasi Mudakkusalai, which is 19 kilometers from Karur on the Karur District Highway. Like this video? Share this video. Leave your comment. Don't forget to subscribe this channel. Thank you, friends.